Here we are in the North Conway Scenic Railroad, Crawford Notch train station. Full of wonderful mementos of the past concerning railway. We will be taking the 10:30 train with Zachary. You got everything? Tickets? Here we are back at the fairgrounds, and the tents are going up for the show. This is the Posterfix setup at the Mount Washington Valley Arts and Crafts Show, August 29th, 2009. It has been raining excessively here over the past night, causing excessive moisture in my tent and thereby causing some curling in the linen backing. The pieces that have stayed on the table have remained flat, but the ones that are hung up have curled a bit due to the moisture. Lesson learned. Thank you.
Come on, what's her name? Come on, I can't say it. Don't shut.
Uncle Henry!
It's Uncle Henry and
Uncle
Henry.
Hello there.
Hey.
Hello.
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 Oh, God love you. Don't even look at me.
I'm not, I'm looking at your
Oh, the radio? Look at this radio. 1938 Zenith.
They don't make them like this anymore.
No, they don't.
Do they, Uncle Henry?
No.
No, I don't think so.
Did you see that, the old mirror over here?
Yeah, that's beautiful.
Up there, that's
fair wear and tear?
That comes in with the years, you know. It's just like a car or school. It wears out.
Memorabilia of him?
I remember. Listen, at my age, you forget. I was in the 366 Medical Battalion in the northern part of France, in the Saint-Nazaire sector, pinning down 60,000 German troops until the end of the war in the ETO, ETO means Europe, 1945, May the 8th.
Yeah,
that's it.
Amazing. And then you were invading, you came in on a ship, right?
We came in on a ship, oh yeah.
And what happened to the ship in front of you?
Oh yeah, that was an LST. There was at least 1,500 soldiers on the LST. He was maybe 400 or 500 feet ahead of us. We were headed for France. Okay, we could see the lights of France, maybe a couple of miles. And then all of a sudden, that ship got blasted by a German submarine torpedo. And there was at least 1,200 soldiers that went down that day.
Oh.
As a matter of fact, there was a guy by the name of Bouchard from Berlin that was on that ship.
Ah,
he used to be a brakeman for the Brown Company. And he didn't go down with it.
Huh.
There's another ship that pulled up alongside, and he jumped up on it. And it was like this, and the ocean goes like this.
Yeah.
And when he jumped, the ship was coming up, and he landed there, and he bumped his chin on his knees.
Oh.
But he lived.
Yeah. Unbelievable.
Then what did they?
But they didn't blow your ship out of the water, did they?
And I says, that's when I said, hey, I said, I bet we're going to be next. No, he was right in front of us. But no, we reached France. I forget the name, it's a little town of France.
In Cherbourg?
That's where we landed. You know, when that ship got blasted there, we could see the lights off Cherbourg.
Cherbourg.
A couple of miles, and we made it there. I thought for sure we were going to be next.
Yeah.
But we made it. Northern part.
Did you have to get off the ship then, or you stayed on the ship?
Then we got off the ship.
Yeah. When did you have a chance of meeting Walter Cronkite, Uncle Henry?
When we was walking the streets of Rome, and we went into that restaurant at 8 o'clock at night, a spaghetti restaurant, with my chum, my friend. We sat down at the table. There was three or four chairs. He sits there and I sit here. He says, and you know, this man comes over and sits across the table and he says, you boys don't have, forget the bill. He says, I'll take care of it. Well, I said, before I go, I'd like to know your name, who you are. He says, I am Walter Cronkite.
Oh.
And I remember that like I remember you.
Zachary's back. Give him five, Zachary. Zachary, where are you going? Light. Zachary, come back here.
Mommy's got to watch Zachary.
Yeah, Mommy is very busy. Okay, guys, see you later.
Okay. See you later, Chris.
See you.
Yeah.